Let's see if this can work. See, I'm not sure about you, but it's very strange to just like look back on the year and wonder if it went too fast or too quickly. Because I feel like everybody I asked had a different answer to that. I don't know what's going on in whatever, wherever you are, whoever's watching, but right now over here, school has started again. And this is my returning semester after taking gap year, just earning money, doing that big trip in the States, just learning about these other things when it comes to making music and all that shit. And I was kind of nervous because, quite frankly, the first semester of school that I experienced was not fun. I was not able to make any friends within school. There was this one guy who talked to me in this one class, and I thought, at first I thought, okay, maybe this is gonna be the guy that I'll be hanging out with. But eventually he started saying things like, you know, people who kill themselves are weak. And eventually I realized this guy was basically a toxic Reddit thread just realized into a human being. I am also a very extremely online person, but I am not that kind of internet nerd. So I started to just like not talk to him at a certain point. And you know, the whole online class thing is very new to me, so I was like, okay, maybe what if I don't know what's going on? What if I don't know where to go, where to click or whatever? But it turns out I completely forgot about the fact that I used to get good grades in high school and that I used to be pretty good at studying. Because once the class actually started and once I actually started doing all the assignments or whatever, I sort of found everything very easy. Also, I think now that school's started, I'm not sleeping more than 11 hours a day, which I think is good for me because once you get past 12 hours a day, your body basically starts to assume you're dead. And it just starts to just crumble down. Unfortunately, I'm still very tired because I still can't go for more than 2 days without working out. Because if I don't work out for more than 2 days in a row, I start hating myself and I start having body issues. And I also think that this whole online class system is pretty good, at least for me, because I am absolutely terrible at in-person first impressions. I think even my longtime friends, as of right now, still tell me about how they felt when they first met me and how awkward I was. Because I feel like when I first meet people, I can be a nice person. It really depends on the person. But most of the time, I either say too little or I say too much. I either don't say anything or I literally reveal my entire life history and all my just like secluded traumas onto this one person, and I just become too much or barely existing. Which I guess is the great thing about social media. You basically plaster your entire personality and your life on your page, and the person can just like look through all that stuff and just kind of get an idea of who you are and then talk to you. It's like a premeditated introduction, a premeditated portfolio. And yeah, obviously social media completely sucks your soul away. It makes you completely dependent on the chemical reactions to watching a notification come up. But still, it can at least get rid of that awkward first impression thing. And you know, where's the fun in being happy with yourself anyways? We should all constantly strive to be the person that we will genetically and physically and mentally probably never will be. Isn't that what like fucking Camus talked about, or one of those dead white philosophers who had way too much fucking time on their hands? I have been thinking a bit about social media here and there. And I don't know why. There are two things I started thinking about social media. Both just sort of like these random thoughts that I've started having. I started to see the dark side of social media once I started using Instagram, which is a fun app. You can do a lot of fun things. You can actually connect with a lot of people through it, thankfully, because of the whole DM system. But the thing is, you also sort of you put too much meaning into certain things. Like, I posted a comment on an Angel Olsen video that she uploaded, and I said just some stupid thing like, oh, you know, that whole fucking your mountain cabin fucking Huntsman hair is coming in good. And she liked the comment, which is a thing that artists do to interact with their fans. It's just something they do. It's kind of like part of their job. But I, like, for, like, that like, that single like from her made my day to a point where it was almost depressing. Like, I was both very happy, but I was also, like, acknowledging the fact that this was making my day, and this was getting me out of bed and making me do things. And I was realizing that I've become so dependent on these forms of acknowledgments from people that I admire, or just people in my regular life. And it's clearly not a good thing. There's no way this is a good thing. I started having this idea of maybe I'm too old for social media, which is very stupid considering the fact that most people on social media aren't even fucking teenagers. They're mostly, like, especially like Twitter and Instagram, they're mostly millennials. They're mostly people who are actually older than me. So I don't know. It's not like I'm gonna stop using it. It's too late for me. I'm like completely down the rabbit hole. I am all in on fucking Instagram at this point. And it's depressing. There's a part of me that kind of regrets it, but at the same time, I'm actually interacting with way more people than I used to before, thanks to Instagram. So yeah, maybe it's not necessarily. I'm not going into Twitter. Twitter seems to be like literally the last circle of hell that you go into, because everything that I've heard about Twitter so far, I have heard like. People who use Twitter have told me to not use Twitter. Like, they've told me that Twitter's just a terrible addiction. Like, people are just arguing and spewing things, just like this chimera monster of every aspect of the humanity that you hate is basically Twitter. So basically, so far, people who smoke tell me not to smoke, even though they're smoking right in front of me, and people who use Twitter tell me not to use Twitter, even though they're still very active on Twitter. So, you know, Twitter's basically the smoking of social media. Facebook is probably the drinking of social media, and Instagram is probably just, like, fucking recreational drugs of social media. So I'm gonna stick with the drugs and not go to smoking. That's the smart thing to do. Also, this room is way too hot, and this blanket is just too much now. Yeah, goodbye.